Hill. Hill with two men on him. Catches it. A monster touchdown.
This is where the Panthers' drive for the top started, on the practice field. Once again, expectations for this Permian football team were high when the year started. Number one in the state in the Texas High School Coaches Poll. Number two in the Associated Press Poll, no lower than fourth in any poll at all, with very little experience returning. The Panthers were not tested in their first outing of the season, a 55-0 blitz at El Paso Austin. But in week two, Mojo survived one of their stiffest tests of the season against the Marshall team that came in ranked 10th in the state. Tied 7-7 at a half, Arve Villa took matters in his own hands and legs. On the day, he finished with 202 yards on 11 carries. None prettier than this 87-yarder. From a loss the year before in Marshall was sweet.
A Mojo touchdown!
21 points in the second quarter against Amarillo was enough for the win there. Stoney Case threw for 138 yards in the first half, and Permian closed out their pre-district schedule with a 28-0 win. When Permian opened District 4-5A play against rival Odessa High, Chris Comer was the story. A career-high 273 yards, a record 5 rushing touchdowns.
And that's the Mojo touchdown.
The offensive showdown belonged to Mojo, and Permian had beaten the Broncos for the 27th time in 31 outings. Against Midland High, the defense made their mark on the Bulldogs, giving up just 140 total yards and 7 first downs. The offense had scored 44 points by halftime on their way to a 51-0 pacing.
Hey, Villa, trying to beat one man and will do so and take it in.
Against the Abilene Eagles in the third week of district play, the game was again over by halftime when the score was 34-0. Arve Villa scored twice, picked up 123 yards in just 7 carries. Permian took their unbeaten record into a non-district game with Dallas Jesuit. It was another shutout, another offensive explosion, another game over by halftime, another win, 40-0.
He has one man to beat, and beats it. A Mojo touchdown.
Back to 4-5A play and shutout number 6 in the year. If anyone thought the Panthers were looking ahead to Lee the following week, they found out early, with Permian scoring 28 points in the first quarter. Mojo knew what they had to do against Cooper. Chris Comer returned from a knee injury to score twice on his way to a 74-yard night. Lloyd Hill, who returned a punt for a touchdown in the first quarter, brought the crowd to their feet with this grab.
And that's the Mojo touchdown!
Then the game that brought the district bell back where it belongs. Permian led 10-6 at the half on the Case to Hill touchdown, along with an Alan Stewart field goal. For the first time all year long, Permian trailed when Lee's pair of scramblers scored. Mojo responded with an 80-yard drive and took the lead back 17-13. When did Permian celebrate victory? It wasn't until the clock showed all zeros, with the game ending with this classic goal line stand.
They are mojoing over in Permian's side of the stands.
Season ended November 10th at Ramlin Stadium. The game ended as the previous 9 had. Another Panther victory, a perfect 10-0 record. This one led by quarterback Stoney Case, who ran for 2 touchdowns and threw for 3. And the defense, another shutout. But the fun was just starting.
That's Arve Villa, and that's a Mojo touchdown, the first of the playoffs, and Permian takes the lead.
The road to the state championship started in Lubbock. Again, Permian took control early, and for the second time this year, beat Amarillo. This time for a bi-district championship.
Case looking for Lloyd Hill, and that's a Mojo touchdown. Case fakes the throw, now looks deep for Arve Villa, who has it inside the 10, down to the 4-yard line. He says Adrian Villa in motion. Chris Comer has the ball, and that's a Mojo touchdown. The second stick off the clock, and the Permian Panthers, on the road to a state championship, have claimed the bi-district title with a 42-0 win over Amarillo.
Round two, the Panthers stopped the state's regular season leading rusher, Andre Session, on their way to another big victory, 49-6 the final, over El Paso Jefferson.
And that's a Mojo touchdown. Chris Comer from 1 yard out. Joe Ray at quarterback, 5'10", 160-pound senior, and there he is, Andre Session, his first carry, and he's stopped as soon as he gets the football. No gain on the first play, it's 2nd and 10. On the delay to Session, he's hit again, he's down again. Case looking for Lloyd Hill. Hill with two men on him, catches it, back, a Mojo touchdown. Lloyd Hill in double coverage, catches it for 6. Receivers wide right, wide left. Carvajal to the right, but instead of keeping it around, wide in. And that was Juan Flores that was racked up. Ray up, looks to throw. Blocked, pushed back by the Panther defense. That was Chris McMillan. Tony Case looks to throw. Case has time. Now comes out of the pocket, looking downfield for Lloyd Hill. And it's completed down the 15-yard line. Lloyd Hill catches the ball. Case takes the handoff, looks to throw. Can't find a receiver, still looking, puts it in the air, and that's a Mojo touchdown! Tony Case to Alan Wyatt. There's the last play of the ball game, and the Permian Panthers, for the second year in a row, claim the area championship.
Permian's last game at Ratliff Stadium in 1989 was a showcase for the offense, a season-high 584 yards on their way to a classic 49-6 final over Fort Worth Trimble Tech.
Shifts the Permian's home for the next 3 weeks. Texas Stadium in Irving. A battle of two unbeaten teams. Permian shows they can come from behind. Permian shows they can beat Lamar in the quarterfinals for the second year in a row. From Texas Stadium in Irving, it's the quarterfinal 5A matchup featuring two unbeaten hopefuls for the state championship. Our score from Texas Stadium is Lamar 10 and Permian nothing. And that's a Mojo touchdown! Permian is going back to the Final Four.
No matter what you think, oh, you'll
drive for a state championship is still alive. Unbeaten at 14-0, headed back to the semifinals for the third year. Yes, Mojo had been here before to the state semifinals, but this time they had their mojo working, and Permian eased past Marshall for victory number 15. And welcome to Texas Stadium, the Permian Panthers and the Marshall Mavericks. Case looking, has Faulkner open, and that's a mojo touchdown!
We got our mojo working, and we know it's gonna work on you. We got our mojo working, and we know it's gonna work on you. Well, we're gonna have a party, that's what we're gonna do. Want you to come along. Yeah, we're going home talking, and won't you come along? Just forget all your troubles and help us sing this song.
Since 1985, Permian was back in the state championship game, showing everyone what Mojo fans knew all along. In 1989, Permian was the best.
Odessa Permian, for the third time this decade, has won the state 5A championship.
You're simply the best. Oh,
the Texas State High School Football Playoffs. This is great.
This is outstanding.
It's the best feeling of life right now.
It's never felt anything like it. It's the best feeling I've ever had.
They played with heart from day one, and I think that heart goes a long way.
Way to go, baby.
Everybody's always talking about who's on top. Don't cross our path, cause you're gonna get stopped. We ain't gonna give anybody any slack. And if you try to keep us down, we're gonna come right back. And you know we're hanging tough.
Production. That's a Mojo Touchdown!